Hello children, good morning. This is English for class 11. Today's topic is letter writing. You can see there business official letters class 11 format. Letters are written communications. Writing letter is an art and is mastered through practice. The importance of letter writing cannot be overemphasized. Letters develop social discourse, strengthen business relations and win over the officers and employers. Yes. Letters, why do we write letters, children? Basically to maintain a good relationship. Yes. Kinds of letters. Letter writing can be divided into two main kinds, formal and informal. Formal letters include business letters, applications for jobs, letters to editors, letters to principal, officers, and letters of complaints to authorities. Okay. Informal letters are written to friends, relatives, acquaintances, means people whom you know, and teachers. These include private and personal matters such as condolences, congratulations, invitations, etc. Note, the syllabus specifies the following letter types. Letters to editors. Okay. And of course, school, college, authorities and all that. Okay, structure of a formal letter. This is the structure. A formal letter has 7 parts. The address of the sender, including the date, the inside address, the salutation, subject, heading, the body of the letter, the subscription, and of course the signature. Each part begins on the left hand side margin. The block format is used and there is no indentation. One line may be left to indicate the beginning of a new part or paragraph. The address of the sender. The complete address of the sender is written on the top of the page, preferably on the left side without punctuation marks. Example, 237 Jyoti Apartments, Ashok Vihar, New Delhi, 110048. The date is written just below the sender's address. In formal letters, dates can be written as under 10th July 2011 or July 10, 2011. Both are acceptable. The former is the British style while the latter is the American style. In our country, mostly we follow the British style. But these days, some people have started using the American style. Students should avoid writing dates such as 10, 7, 11. So most of you have the habit of that, yes, of writing date like this as it is shown here. 10.7. No, children, no. The inside address. The inside address is written below the date line after leaving some space. So look at the example there. Before the name of firms trading under an impersonal name such as Golden Carriers, Karnataka Small Industries. However, the word MS. Messer should not be used before the what name of firms trading under impersonal name. Okay. Before the name of firms beginning with a singular proper noun such as Gupta Sales and all that. Okay. Anil Hardware and all that. Salutation or greeting. The writer uses appropriate words for the receiver according to his or her relation. The salutation comes just below the address of the recipient. Who is the recipient? The one who receives is the recipient. Its first and last word should be written with a capital letter. A comma may be put after the salutation. In business letters, we write dear sir, dear sirs. Yes. In official letters, applications or letters to the editors, we write. You have already done this. Letter to the editor, sir, dear sir, respected. Yeah. Subject heading. Mention the heading of the subject below the salutation. In the middle, the subject should be mentioned briefly. Yes, of course. This helps in speedy compliance and disposal. The body of the letter, that is the content. Yeah, it is the most important part of the letter. It contains the actual message to be conveyed. It may be broken into various paragraphs, each paragraph dealing with only one idea. So each paragraph deals with only one idea. Okay, you cannot write 3-4 ideas. You just cannot put in 3-4 ideas in one paragraph. Is that clear to you? Okay, begin with a new paragraph. Each time you say something new. Yes, a formal letter must have at least 3 paragraphs in the body of the letter. Introductory para, main body of the letter, and of course the concluding para. The subscription, it is also called the complimentary clause. It should agree in style and tone with the salutation. If you have used sir, madam in your salutation, then the ending should be accordingly. Yours faithfully. So it should be accordingly written. Yeah. Okay. Now, however, if the person addressed is known to the writer, you can address as dear sir or madam. Yours sincerely may be used. Do not write truly. So do not write yours truly. Okay, yours doesn't have an apostrophe. And remember, thanking you is grammatically wrong. Thanking you is grammatically and should not be used. Beginning with to ending a letter with from. Okay, the format of a letter is on the left side. The signature, of course, is very important. Some optional parts. Reference number, it appears between the writer's address. Here you may give file number, letter number, and all that. Okay, enclosures, ENCL you can write, copy, CC if it is necessary to send a copy, then okay. Guidelines, writing good business letters, be brief, clear, concise, precise, to the point, very important. You have to use a proper format, proper layout, very important. Yes. Punctuation marks, again, very important. Do not mix the two formats. Do not write confusing letter. You have to convey facts briefly but impressively. You have to indicate the theme in the initial para of the body of the letter. Then you have to develop your points in the middle paragraph and conclude. Then you have to give suggestions in the final paragraph. Use simple and direct language. Avoid the use of long and high sounding words and ambiguous constructions. Be courteous, be polite. Even while lodging a complaint or criticizing, you should be polite and charming. See, never be ambiguous, okay? Do not use confusing words. Remember the following points about block format. There is no indentation. Each block begins with a margin on left hand side. Extra space should be left between different sections and paras. Omit punctuation marks in address, date or salutation. In case you put a comma in the address, use it throughout. Do not mix the two systems. See, this is the marking scheme generally. What is the golden rule? See, use suitable format, well organized content. Yeah. So these are very important. See, letter to editor, this is the format. See, sender's address, pin code, of course, very important, date, address of the address. See, the pin, subject, introductory para, main body of the letter, concluding para, complimentary clause, content. See, the content of the letter must be well organized to ensure clarity and effective communication. The content is divided into 3 main parts. The introductory paragraph introduces the theme. The main part deals with the problem. It is the real content of the letter. The tone should be formal. Look at that, letter to editor, then letter to principal or other authorities, simple and direct, formal but polite. For the convenience of the students, the letters have been arranged in the following order. Okay, you are Vidya Vidhan Sharma, living at 63B block, Greater Kailash, New Delhi. You came across this advertisement. Yeah. children, here it is textile designing, fashion designing, interior designing. It's not that much visible here, this side. Okay, I read it out for you. Okay, IIFT, International Institute of Fashion Technology, that's the advertisement. Write an application to the course director asking him to send you the information brochure and application form. You are particularly interested in textile designing. So this is how you have to answer. 63B block, Greater Kailash, New Delhi, 110048. Then you leave a line, then you write the date. Don't write 17.8. No, that's wrong, children. After that, again leave a line. Then the course director, International Institute of Fashion Technology, M15 second floor, M block, GK part 1, New Delhi, 110048. Again leave a line, then you begin the letter, dear sir. After that, again leave a line, then write the subject. What is the subject of the letter? Course in textile designing. I came across your advertisement in the Times of India of 16th July about the courses offered by your institute. I'm interested in knowing more about the course in textile designing. I've completed AISSC and now wish to join a professional course in textile designing. Kindly let me know if I'm eligible for it. Further, please let me know the duration of the course and the fee. I would also like to know the procedure for obtaining admission. I shall be grateful for an early response. Please send me the brochure and an application form. Children, the correct pronunciation is brochure, not broucher. Broucher, I think some of you say that, right? No, it's wrong. Brochure. Yours faithfully, Vidhan Sharma. Okay, next question. As the head boy of your school, write a letter to the principal requesting him to organize an excursion to Haridwar for an adventure holiday like white water rafting, rock climbing and mountaineering. Okay, K257 Carton Nagar, Delhi, 110000 whatever, 5848. Leave a line, then write the date. See, that's how the date is written. Don't write 6.5. No, leave a line, then write the principal, Bhagirathi Public School, 40 feet road, Carter Nagar, Delhi. Of course, the pin code you have to write. Leave a line, dear sir. Again, leave a line, then write the subject. What's the subject here? Request to organize an excursion for an adventure holiday. Then you begin. On behalf of the students of class 11, I request you to kindly arrange an adventure holiday for us. As this is our last year in school, we would like to have a 4 to 5 days holiday in the Himalayas where we can go for white water rafting, rock climbing and mountaineering. We feel our March holidays following a final examination are ideal for such an excursion. The time between sessions can be utilized for this purpose. I hope you will consider our request favorably. Thanking you, yours faithfully, head boy XYZ. As the head boy of your school, write a letter to the principal requesting him to make internet facilities available to students in the library. Answer, your address. See, that's how you write it. Date, then the principal, leave a line. Nav Shiksha Niketan, that's the full address, okay, of the school. Then leave a line, dear sir. Again, leave a line, the subject, very important, has to be written. Request for internet facilities for students in the library. On behalf of the entire students' body of our school, I request you to please provide internet facilities in the library. Due to dearth of internet facilities, we feel quite inadequate. When we come in contact with students of other schools, this facility will improve the quality of our work in all areas. Our project presentations will become more meaningful and our debates and speeches will be well researched. As you always put the students' growth on top priority, please consider our request favorably. Thanking you, yours faithfully, head boy. As the head boy of your school, write a letter to the principal requesting him for improvements in the school canteen. The hygienic conditions as well as the menu need to be looked into. This is how you write your address, leave a line, date. Again, leave a line, the principal, name of the school, pin code, place, leave a line, date. Dear sir, subject, request to improve the school canteen. On behalf of the entire student community, I request you to improve the school canteen. The canteen needs to be improved in all areas. The menu it offers is extremely limited and boring. The staff is unable to cope with the rush during recess. Therefore, a self-help counter would be of great help. Most important, the hygienic conditions in the kitchen need to be looked into. Regular treatment is essential to eliminate cockroaches and other insects. The owner contractor should issue gloves and aprons to the staff to ensure cleanliness. I hope you will consider our request favorably. Thanking you, yours faithfully, of course, head boy. Yeah. As the head boy of your school, write a letter to the principal requesting him for improvements in an updating of the school auditorium, especially the lights and sound systems which are old and outdated. So, this is your address, leave a line, date, leave a line, principal APJ School, Saket, New Delhi, 1100. That's a pin code, dear sir. Subject, request for updating the school auditorium. On behalf of the students' community, I seek to draw your attention to the pitiable condition of the school auditorium. The seating section is satisfactory, but the balcony needs some additional fans. It becomes very hot and stuffy during July, August, and the audience gets restless. The stage requires changes. The sound system is obsolete, means outdated, and needs to be changed. Similarly, we have very limited lights on the stage. If we could have the updated innovations in lighting, it would improve our cultural programs tremendously. Similarly, the green rooms need to have better mirrors and lights, and an additional changing room if possible in the girls' section. With these improvements, our auditorium will be an asset to the school. Thanking you, yours faithfully, XYZ. Children, have a look at the questions and answers once again. This is for your benefit. Look at the question. There's an advertisement given there. Okay. Fashion designing, textile designing, interior designing, degrees, courses offered. Then that's the question. Have a look at it. Read it very carefully. Okay. Then there's the answer there. Write your address on top, leave a line, then write the date. That's how you have to write the date. Not 17.6. No, that's wrong. Some of you write like that, but that's wrong. Never write like that. After that, leave a line. The course director, the address of that institute. Then again, leave a line. Then, dear sir, that's how you have to address, and subject is a must. After that, the body of the letter. Please go through very carefully, children. Body of the letter is divided into paragraphs. Yours faithfully, Vidhan Sharma. That's the second question, children. Okay? That's how you answer it. Your address. Leave a line, date, leave a line, address of the principal, that is the name of the school. Then leave a line, dear sir, was a subject, request to organize an excursion for adventure holiday. So that's how you have to write, that's the body of the letter. Please read it very carefully, write down in your notebooks. That's how you write that. I hope you will consider our request favorably. Thanking you, yours faithfully. Head boy. Then we move on to the next question. Go through the question very carefully. Read the questions very carefully, and that's how you answer. Don't forget to write the subject. Then that's the body of the letter. Read it very carefully. Go through very carefully. Don't make any mistake. Okay? This is about internet facility. Yes, requesting for internet facilities. See how it is divided into paragraphs. And then thanking you, yours faithfully. Who's written this letter? Head bar. So that's all for this session, children. Go through all that we have done in this session. Write down in your notebooks. Thank you. Goodbye.